So we finished with the ASN1 syntax last lecture. Now we will study another important aspect is the encoding. How do I encode it into bits of ones and zeros, or you can consider a stream of ones and zeros. So the encoding is called as TLV encoding. So today we will be studying about the basics of TLV encoding, and then at the end of the lecture, might be we will be able to apply the TLV encoding for certain data types. See, there are many data types, okay, but we will not be covering the entire data type. So very few data types will be there, okay, and we will be encoding those data types only. So whatever we are practicing in the class or it is there in the notes, we will be highlighting on that only, or similar type of example just with the data change. So don't prepare a whole lot, because it's just one or two questions that might come from this particular section. And I expect that you write everything, because there will be certain things which you will require and you don't have anything in front of you to apply. Okay, certain tags will be there. Okay, some values, predefined values will be there. And when you are given ki chalo iska encoding karo, you need what is iska length kitna hona chahiye, iska tag kya hai. Okay, so those are all predefined. Okay, so and since I said very few data types are there, okay, so 8-10 rahenge, tumko wo 8-10 ka hi yaad rakhna padega. Okay, so but for that you will require to know that. So I will expect that you write all those things, so that later on there is no confusion. When I give you a certain example to solve on your own, the table will help you to encode it. Okay, now we had seen this particular diagram earlier also. Data types, that is the tag and data type. So data types are defined based on structures and tag. In ASN1, we had seen the various structures, like what is a simple structure, structured, what is other, tag. Now today we are going to concentrate on the tag. Now, what is tag? Tag uniquely identifies the data type. Now that tag is of two types, class tag and number tag. That class tag is again is classified into universal, application, context specific, private. So this block diagram we have already seen, and in ASN1 we covered this 4 types, but we are told to encode only simple types. Okay, so hum log complex type, that is structured, tagged and other types ASN1 coding hum logon ne nahi kiya hai. We restricted ourselves to simple type. Similarly, when I talk of tag, we have universal, application, context specific and private. So we will, I have shown you a table also, universal tag. Okay, so we will restrict ourselves to universal tag. Okay, but if a short note is asked, then you need to explain about what is universal, what is application, what is context specific and what is private. But agar encoding pucha jayega, so it will be only about the universal tag. Okay, so both ways the questions can be asked. Okay, so now continuing with this, hence onward, you will be writing whatever is there in the slide. Okay, now what is tag? Okay, I have various data, okay, data types, and a tag uniquely identifies a data type. Like when you go to buy certain things from the shop, there is a tag attached to it. So what the tag is, like in the tag, there will be some barcode, or just an example I'm giving. So that barcode might indicate that, okay, this item is so and so. Suppose a t-shirt, okay, of this particular brand. Okay, so that tag is uniquely identify that piece of cloth, that it is a t-shirt, either it is for men or women. It is specifying ki acha iska itna size hai, M hai, L hai, XL hai. Okay, so there is a tag attached. So similarly, here we are calling that tag which is uniquely identifying the data type. Agar maine integer bola, my data type is an integer. So integer ka tag kya hoga? Suppose I have octet string. Okay, like we have visible string, we have octet string, which is a combination of letters and numbers. So agar octet string hai, to uska tag kya hoga? Suppose I am sending an IP address. So what is the tag of an IP address? Okay, so for various data types, there is a tag. एंड दैट टैग इज ओनली वन. जो इंटीजर के लिए टैग होगा वो इसके लिए नहीं होगा, ऑक्टेट स्ट्रिंग के लिए नहीं होगा, आईपी एड्रेस के लिए नहीं होगा. ओके, सो वी नीड टू रिमेम्बर दैट टैग, बिकॉज इफ यू डोंट रिमेम्बर दैट टैग वी कैनॉट एनकोड द डेटा. सो ओनली 7-8 टैग्स यू नीड टू रिमेम्बर फ्रॉम द पर्टिकुलर टेबल. ओके, नाउ द टैग इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर एनकोडिंग द डेटा टाइप्स फॉर कम्युनिकेशन, कम्युनिकेशन मैनेजमेंट रिलेटेड कम्युनिकेशन. Every data type except choice and any have data tags associated with them. This choice and any, okay, was present in other structure. जब हमारे पास कुछ भी नहीं है, choice of stream any डाल दिया, okay, choice of branch, okay, so we put, so choice or any is like एक हमारे लिए loophole है in ASN1, you can say. If I don't know hardcore ASN1 syntax, then I can put this choice and any. So since this choice and any are not so serious kind of ASN1, so that's why it does not have a tag. Except this two, every data type has a tag associated with them. Okay, now tag, it is again composed of two components. There is a class and there is a tag number. Okay, so we need to know what is the class and the tag number. So there are four classes of tags. So what are those four classes? Universal class, application, context specific, and private. See, this is ye wala hum bol rahe. Class tag is again having a class tag and a number tag. So class tag is universal, application, context specific, and private. Now let us see the definition. As I said, from the short note viewpoint, you will require these things. So what are universal? So they are universal means the most common. They are like global variable in a software program. So that's why it is given the name universal. Okay, so it's the most commonly used. Okay, and we define it like a global variable. Agar ASN1 bhi coding likh rahe hum log, so some data types you declare and that data type will be used throughout the program. Okay, so that's why they are universal tag. Application, from the name, it is used only for a specific application, so it overrides the universal. So a global variable hai uske upar, if I am focusing on a particular application, then I will use the application class. Then context specific. Okay, so for certain specific context, again in an application, I might use the context specific class. Private, okay, the private class, it is extensively used by commercial vendors. So we can see that ki ye tino cheez hamare kaam ka nahi hai, but yes, from the definition viewpoint, we should be knowing, because we are only dealing with the universal one, the most common one. Okay, because we are not going for a specific application, neither in any context in a specific application, neither we are bothering about what the commercial vendors are using privately. So this three is not in our domain. So we will be concentrating on the universal tags. Okay, and only some of the universal tags. Okay, abhi se you will write and draw everything. What is the encoding structure? So please draw this. So encoding structure, BER encoding structure, we are following. So three fields are there. So the first one is, please draw it. I hope that you are drawing. The first field, three fields are there. Pehle field ko hum type bolte hain. Next field, we call it as the length. And the last field, we call it as the value. So TLV. So what is TLV encoding? Type, length, value. In some book or some places, you will also see that TLV ka full form hai, tag, length, value. Okay, the tag word is present in type only yahan pe hai. So tag length value or type length value, all are one and the same thing. So the encoding structure. So what we are doing in that encoding structure, the ASCII text in ASN1, we are writing something. Okay, textual description. So those ASCII texts are converted into bit-oriented data, that is streams of ones and zeros. So the encoding, we are calling it as type, length, value. So the first field on the left hand side is type, beech mein length hai, last mein value hai. Okay, now type is again divided into three fields. Okay, type 8 bit ka hai, 7 and 8th bit tells you about the class. 6th bit is P oblique C. We will see what is P and what is C, primitive oblique construct. And 1 to 5th bit is the tag number. Okay, so when I am writing type ka jo value hai, it will be 8 bit. Okay, so 7th and 8th bit will tell you about the class. 6th bit will tell you primitive or construct, P oblique C. Right now, write only P oblique C. And 1 to 5th bit will tell you the tag number. So right now, we are just discussing about type. Then we will discuss length and then the value. Yahan tak likho. Ya draw karo, just EF structure. Please draw it. Because you need to count, you need to put something. And all this we are doing for the first time. Once you finish drawing, you let me know. So what is TLV? It is the encoding structure where the ASCII text are converted into bit-oriented data. Okay, so that is your TLV encoding, type, length, value. Okay, so the type has three subcomponents. That is a class, that is PC and tag number. PC specifies whether the structure is primitive. Okay, that is a simple type. Okay, so agar simple type hai, so it is P, or C stands for construct type. Construct type, we are not calling it as complex. Anything other than simple, we call it as the construct. So hamara jo P or C hai, okay, since we said we are going for the simple ASN1 structure, so your P oblique C mein hamara, the structure will be primitive only. Okay, so construct ke liye hum nahi jayenge. Okay, and then in the class, we have these four classes. Okay, ye wale. Universal class, application, context specific, private. So again, I said we will be using the universal. So you just need to know universal ka tag kya hai. Application, context specific, private, we are not using. Okay, so yaha pe we already know it is the universal class. Since we are going for, see, there are many classes, but hamare syllabus ki baat kar rahi hu. 6th bit P or C mein we are going for the simple structure, so it is a primitive. So P ka jo encoding rahega, we are using that. And then tag number, you have to remember this tag number, certain tag numbers which I will give you. Now, universal, which the class, which is consisting of 8th bit and 7th bit. So agar universal hai, so 8th and 7th bit will be, please write this all, otherwise you don't know ki kaun sa bit 0 hai, 1 hai. So if the class is universal, 8th and 7th bit is 00, application ke liye 01, context specific ke liye 10, private ke liye 11. Now since I said we are using the universal, so tumko yaad rakhna hai 8th or 7th bit is 00. Kahan pe 00 hai? In type. Okay, so 8th and 7th bit will be 00. I hope it is clear what we are doing. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so universal, 8th and 7th bit, 00, 01, application, context specific, 10, private, 11. Finished till this point?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, the universal tag, some of the universal tag, not all. And this is all not there in your money. Okay. So it is there in Tannenbaum. Okay, so from Tannenbaum, I have taken all these things because money may serve the approach is that of a short note kind. But during orientation, we were told ki ye, because this is there in SNMP. Okay, so SNMP also uses the same thing. So all these things are there in Tannenbaum. Okay, so I have in my notes, we have things from money and all the same thing is there also in my notes. But just for your sake, it is not there in money. It is from Orozen hai ya Tannenbaum, I don't remember. It will be written from where I have taken. Okay, so what are the universal tags? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Only 10 are there. So please remember it because hamare example mein aayega. So integer, the keyword, the data type, if it is an integer, in hex, the tag is 02. So you can write the one in hex, binary, you know how to convert. You have your calculators and all. Octet string agar hai, the tag is 04. See, if you don't remember this value, you cannot encode a string. Because the moment integer comes, tumko tag. And seeing the tag 02, dekho, hamare paas ones and zeros hai stream mein. Okay, I'm just going back over here. Okay, ones and zeros hai. So, ye hamara ek stream hai, ones and zeros. Okay, pehla do class bol rahe, 7th and 8th, 6th is primitive. When I see the tag number, okay, when I try to decode it, seeing the streams of 1 to 5th bit, mujhe pata chalega ki wo data jo hai, wo integer hai, ya octet string hai, ya IP address hai. And that tag number is unique. So even if you know this, even if you know this, but if you don't know the tag, the marks you will not get because this is unique and you have only this much to remember. So integer ka tag 02, octet string 04, object identifier, we had seen object identifier, internet ka object identifier 1.3.6.1 was there. Okay, so every data or level or a root node has an object identifier. So object identifier is 0.6. Null value hai 0.5. Sequence ya sequence of. We have used this in ASN1. So that tag number is 30. Okay. So sometimes they will tell you encode it or write the answer in hex or they will tell you write it in binary form. Okay, if nothing is asked, you are expected to do both. Koi examiner hex ki value check kar raha, expect kar raha hoga. If it is a written exam, for MCQ, if such questions are asked, you can see the streams and you can understand ki haan, aise numbers hai, it will be in hex. And if it's only ones and zeros, it is in binary. IP address agar hai, the tag for IP address is 40. If counter is there, the tag is 41. Gauge 42, time ticks 43, OPEC 44. So these are only 10 data types given. See, there are many, many data types. Hum logon ne kitna kuch use kiya tha, implicit, application, in those 2-3 examples only that we have done. But we are not doing all those data types. Only these 10 you need to know and the tag. So quickly write down the Quickly write down this table. Once you finish writing, you let me know. Once you finish this, you tell me.
Done, ma'am.
What about others?
Done, ma'am.
No, ma'am, 1 minute.
Abhiram, done?
Yes, ma'am.
Anil, Adish, Srishti.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Continuing with the TLV. Okay, so the identifier octet, jo T hai. So we had seen 8th bit, 8th and 7th bit is class. Okay, so this is a more colorful diagram. C is P oblique C. So class, we have 00, 01, 10, 11. Okay, for universal, application, context specific, private. We will be mostly using universal. So 7th and 8th bit will be 0. P oblique C is primitive or constructed. Primitive is simple data type. Anything apart from simple is constructed. So the 6th bit, we go for primitive. Okay, so ye hamara ek 0 fix ho gaya aur yahan pe 7th and 8th bit 0, 0. Now 5, 2, 1 is telling you the tag. Okay, so 1 to 5, the lowest 5 bits, it determines the tag. Suppose we consider integer. Okay, so integer ka tag kya hai? If you see the table, integer is 2, tag 2. So, hamare yahan pe 0, 0, 0. The next one is 0. Okay, 6th one is 0. And integer, if I write, it is 2. Integer ka 2. So, it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. So, tumhara jo T hai, the identifier octet, it will be given by this particular stream. So, it is 6, 0, 1 and then 1, 0. So, integer ka jo hai type, it will be given by this particular stream. Is this clear? So, integer belongs to universal class with a tag value 2 and is a primitive data type. Okay. Hence, the type TLV, L to abhi bacha hai, we are just discussing the type, type length value. So, the type for an integer will be always this one. So, if you can remember this, it is very good because integer, octet, string are the ones which we will be using frequently. Okay, so continuing ahead. Now comes, so T, we have finished type. Now next comes length. Okay, so the length specifies the length of the value field in number of octets. See, hum log kya kar rahe? Hamare paas ek data type hai. We are encoding that data type. So I need to tell ki wo data type kis type ka hai. Okay, so for that, we have the type. Okay, then hamara data type ka length kitna hai? I have to specify that. So then the second field is specifying the length of the data type. And the last field is V, that is the value. Okay. Hame pata chala ki, suppose I am sending an IP address, and IP address ka length, I will tell you what is the length. Okay. And then what is the value of the IP address? Suppose I say DBIT ka agar IP address liya, 10.0.1.1. So that value, in the value field, that 10.0.1.1 will be, it will come out from that particular value. Okay, so T will tell me that, okay, I am sending the data of an IP address. The moment I say IP address ka particular length hoga. Okay, so that length I need to fill. And then finally, what is the value? Okay, so right now let us concentrate on the L. So L specifies the length of the value field in number of octets. Okay, so you need to know first what is the value. Value kaisa hai, agar tumhe pata chalega, then only you can write the length field. So in exam, T you can write, then decide the value. Kaisa likhoge tum log, okay, in the string. And then once you write the value, you will come to know ki length kitna hai wo value ka. And length, how do I write? It is defined as a series of octet. If suppose value ka length chota hai, so we call it as short length. If the value field, suppose I say, I write a very big string. Okay, I am a student of Don Bosco College of Engineering. Okay, so it's a very big string. Okay, so one octet is not sufficient to represent that particular value. But suppose I just say hello. Okay, so then to represent hello and I am a student of Don Bosco Engineering, the length will differ. Okay, so the length is either short or one octet. Okay, or I call it as a long, or it is more than one octet. So anything which jiska length mein one octet se mein represent kar paungi, that I call it as the short. And more than one octet, whatever value I want to represent the length of that value, we call it as the long octet. Now the most significant bit, that is the eighth bit, yahan pe length field ka eighth bit is set to zero for short length, and with the low 7 bit indicating the next 7 bit will indicate the length of the value. Okay, so agar mera length is small, or I call it as short, the 8th bit is 0 and the next 7 bit will give me the length of the object. So for L less than 128, I have this short form. If it is greater than 128, okay, so the first 8th bit of the first octet is marked as 1. And rest of the 7 bit of the first octet indicates how many octet will follow to specify the length. So please write this two definition. Okay, if it is a short length, the first bit is 0 and the next 7 bit indicates the length of the value. And if it is a long form, the 8th bit is marked as 1 and rest of the 7 bits, this 7 bits will of the first octet, this is the first octet, K octet, L octet, because I have more number of octets to specify the length. And then rest of the 7 bit will indicate ki kitne octets aur aayenge. Okay, so that is this one. Finished? Can I continue?
Yes, ma'am.
Next comes the last table, which you should be remembering, is the size. Okay, if it is an integer, to represent any integer between, here you can see minus 2 raised to 31 and 2 raised to 31 minus 1, a very big stream of integer, I require 4 bytes. Okay, the size of the integer, the length. So simple data types ke jo length hai, it is specified. So integer, the length of the integer is given by 4 bytes. Okay, so you know what is the length of the integer. Integer 32 bhi agar hai, 4 bytes. Any integer unsigned 32, it is 4 bytes. So you just write down integer ka jo length hai, it is 4 bytes. Now when I talk about octet string, octet string is that visible string or variable string, like jaise hello hai. Now I cannot specify this length because my name is Poonam Chakravarty. Uska ek length hoga. Hi, H-I, hi. Uska ek alag length hoga. Hello, uska ek alag length hoga. Computer, okay. NMT, okay. So all those length when I say it comes under octave string. Okay, so the size in that case is variable. So here when suppose my data type is an octave string. So hi, hi mein H-I hai. So for H, you know, what is the, how do I represent H? Then I, how do I represent I? Agar hello hai, to H-E-L-L-O. Okay, so then you need to write first the value. Okay, and then from that value, H-E-L-L-O ko. Okay, from that table, you have to remember or whatever way, because ab tak to exam mein diya nahi hai. So that table you have to remember ka H ka kya hai, converted E ka kya hai. So that's why the octave string, whenever it comes, the length is not specified, it is variable. Same thing for object identifier also, the length is variable. Because you know, object identifier kaisa hota hai, wo tree, the tree grows. And then the object identifier also grows. Okay, so there are so many levels. So I cannot specify ki haan, object identifier ka length 4 bytes hai. No, it is variable because jo level 3 pe agar jo object identifier hai and level 22 pe, the object identifier will grow or it will be different. So the length of an object identifier is variable. When I talk about IP address, here we are considering only IP version 4. Okay, so that's why an IP address, it is made up of 4 integer only. So that's why to represent an IP address, we require 4 bytes. The length for an IP address is 4 bytes. Okay. Counter 32, 4 bytes. Counter 64, 8 bytes. Gauge, you might feel, ye sab kahan pe aayega? Kahan kahan pe to aata hai? So write down this. So integer, you can club this 3, make it 4 byte, octet string, object identifier, variable, IP address, 4 bytes, counter 4 byte, counter 32, 4 byte, counter 64, 8 byte, gauge 32, 4 byte, time ticks, 4 byte, OPEC, again, it is variable. So we will not use the last two, but ye words hai example mein. Okay, so tag you need to remember and the length. As you will be using, hum dekhenge ki integer bahut zyada bar use hota hai, octet string, object identifier, IP address. These 4 are the ones which are mostly repeated in our example. So you need to know length of an integer, 4 byte, octet string will be variable, object identifier is also variable, IP address is 4 bytes. No need to write the description, only the type and the length. Yahan size likha hai, please write length over here, otherwise again you will be confused. finished writing this table?
No, ma'am.
Okay. No need to write the description, only the type and the length. Done. Yes or no? Hemant, you finished writing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now let us see. So almost explanation is over. Just a moment. Now let us see the encoding structure. Suppose write down the first question. Let us encode an octet string. So this will be specified. Okay. So let us encode an octet string in quotes 0C1BH. This is the first example that we are doing. So let us encode an octet string. And that octet string is given as is given do apostrophe ke andar 0C1BH. So this apostrophe and H, it denotes that this data is in hexadecimal notation. Okay, and remember iska hume type, length, value sab likhna hai. Okay, and the entire thing will be coded in ones and zeros ka string. Now, what is the first hint that is given is, sabse pehle, write the value. Value is ye, 0C1B. Once I write the value, okay, then I will know uska length kitna hai. Type, no problem. Type, I can do it because I know it is an octet string. So, octet string ka type mujhe pata hai. But length, I'll come to know when I write down the actual value. So I hope you have written the question. Encode an octet string 0C1B in hexadecimal. This is the example from the Book of Money. Okay, so hint is first write down the value. So for writing this value, you have this table. Okay, so 0 ka hexadecimal notation is 0 only. Okay, C ka, you need to know what is C. It is 12. The decimal notation for C is 12. Okay, then 1H. So, I have just given this table. I'll project that table later on. I just want to continue with, this is the expanded form. So 0C1B, 0 ka hexadecimal notation is 000 only. C ka agar hum dekhein, what was C? 12. So 1100. 1 ka representation is 0001 and B ka 1011. Okay, 13. So if you see this particular table, B ka 13 hai. Okay, C ka 14 hai, 0 and 1, you know. So what I am doing is, first I'm writing down the value 0, C, then 1 ka and B. And why I have grouped this, I have made one octet. So 8 ka, I am making. Okay, so ye one octet hua, ye one octet hua. Okay, and just to represent one octet, I am just right now leaving a gap. Okay, so tumko ye dikhaya ki 0 ke liye 4 bit hai, C ke liye 4 bit hai, 1 ke liye 4 bit, B ke liye 4 bit. So this is one octet, this is the second octet. Now once I know the value, okay, it was a variable string, octet string. As you know, the length is variable. Toh specify nahi kiya hua tha. Okay, so to know the length, what I did, very first step was I write the value. After writing the value, what will be the length? Can you tell me? The length will be? I've written down the value. Length in octet. It is 2 octet. Ye pehla octet hai aur ye second octet hai. So the length is 2 octet. Okay. Now let us start the T. Tag length value. Mujhe nahi samajh mein aa raha hai ki tum logo ko kitna samajh mein aa raha hai. Okay. So 0C1BH. Okay. So as I said, the class is universal. P oblique C is primitive. It is 0. The length is variable. Now, I have written the length. From here, I can see ye 1 octet hai, ye 2 octet hai. So, the length of this string is 2 octet. Okay. So, please mark it after you write down the value. Why I have separated is to count the octet. So, ye mera pehla octet hai. Aur ye mera second octet hai. So the length of the string is 2 octet. Okay, so the length is variable, but I have counted it is 2. 2 in binary 10 hota hai. So universal 00, primitive ka 0, and the tag number for octet string. What is the tag number for octet string? Just see. Anybody from the table? Yes, tag number for octet string. Kya tha? I hope I'm audible to you. What is the tag number for octet string?
04.
That was in hex. And in binary, it is 00001000. So, tag number for octet string is 04. So, from here, I will take 04. Okay, so the tag for octet string is 04. The length, I even though it is variable, but I counted that the length is 2. 2 octet representation is required, and universal class is universal, and this is primitive. So this is by default, you will remember. So I know class, I know P and C, I know the tag number 04. So mujhe ye pura T pata hai, this is the T. Length I know, it is this. And value I have already written over here. So what will be my answer is this one. Just see. The value, maine pehle 0, C, 1, B ka value likh liya from that table. Okay, then to write the T part, type ka, universal, primitive, and the tag of octet string was 4. So that gave me this tag. Length was 2 octet. So ye mera length hai 2 octet. And this is my value of 0, C, 1, B. So this entire string of ones and zeros agar saath mein hai, so the first 8 bit will tell me the tag, or I call it as one octet. The next octet will tell me the length. Mujhe pata chala ki length 2 octet ka hai from this, so I know that next 2 octet that is following will give me the value. Okay, so from this I will, because see ye hum abhi encoding kar rahe hain, they might give you this stream and they will tell you decode the data. So at decoding you will have to write, suppose ye stream agar tumko diya hai, so at the decoding end you have to see, say that it is an octet string of value 0c1b. Okay, so yahan se tumhe pata chalega ki wo octet string hai, length se pata chalega ki kaisa hai. So there will be four different fields over here, and then the value. From the value you will get the exact octet string. So is this example clear? I don't know, I'm not understanding, because how you are doing 0c1b, we referred to this table to convert it. Ye pura ek table hai. I don't know whether in exam it will be given to you or not. So 0c, okay, 1 yahan pe 1 hai, and b. Okay, so from here we have used this. So either you have to remember this ki A kahan se start ho raha hai, 0 to 9 you know, capital A kahan se start ho raha hai. Okay, so I think you have used this table earlier also, or in your calculator if it is there. This conversion table is there in your calculator?
We can convert it, putting the value.
Can convert it, okay. So agar octet string aaya, to hi tumko ye table dekhna padega, because things might be given in hexadecimal notation also. So at that time you need to use this particular table. So we are not continuing with the next example. So I hope this first example is clear. So the encoding of your octet string 0c1b in hex will be this entire stream. So this is my tag, this is the length, and this is the value. Similarly, we will be doing, next example is integer 14. Okay, so how do I define? How do I define means definition mat likhne baithna. Okay, it is how the TLB encoding, but the question will be define integer 14. And I have written both binary and hexadecimal representation. So we will be defining an integer, octet string to ho gaya. Then again an octet string high. So here this data will change in the exam. Then object identifier, to internet ka hum lenge. So how do I define 1.3.6.1? So all this we will be seeing in the next lecture. And then how do I define an IP address? So once I finish this, okay, I will take the more examples when I'll start with chapter number 3, because in chapter 3 also we have the SNMP, and there also the same thing is there. So wapas ek bar revision ho jayega with the other examples. Okay, all the unsolved of, I think, Tannenbaum ya Porozhan, dono mein se to koi ek book hai, I'm not remembering right now. So uske unsolved jo hai, that is also I have provided the solution in my notes. So practice all those things. IA mein bhi wahi rahega, term end mein bhi wahi se rahega. So you have very few data types and their encoding structure, and it is not, but don't feel, are ye kya hai, students go wrong, tag they go wrong over here because they forget the tag. Length wo log wo 4 bytes hamesha yaad rakhte hai, integer ka 4 bytes hai to sabka 4 bytes hai. So yahan pe 0000000 aise karte char octet likhte hain, because I have corrected for so many years, so they very well remember integer ka 4 byte hai, and for every data type they will write the length as 4 bytes. Okay, so that is not the case. So simple things, you just lose the mark. Okay, so I am ending this lecture today. I'll take the attendance.